Biologists Bill Reiner and Jim O'Donnell are looking for a tiny little bird.
The nest is in the juniper tree, and it's about 6 meters up the tree. And she's sitting on the nest right now.
They are studying an endangered bird that nests only here in the hill country of central Texas.
This is pretty typical of their habitat. They like a more closed forest environment rather than an open, mixed prairie woodland.
This is the bird. It's a tiny warbler, the golden-cheeked warbler, and it's pretty special around these parts.
Golden-cheeked warblers are unique in the sense that they nest nowhere else in the world but in central Texas. There's no other bird in the world that you can say that about, but golden-cheeked warblers, everyone is a native Texan because everyone was born here.
Here in the rolling hills of central Texas is the Balcones Canyonlands Preserve. It's a 30,000-acre preserve right in the middle of a continually growing city of Austin. And this preserve is where Bill and Jim monitor these rare warblers.
I found the nest 2 days ago. It was a female golden-cheeked warbler. The female does all the building. She uses primarily the bark of ash juniper trees for the structure of the nest, and then she binds it together with sticky materials like spider webbing.
It turns out these unique birds only nest here because they are dependent upon hill country ash juniper, or commonly known as cedar trees.
The golden-cheeked warbler is only going to breed in this particular habitat. They build their nest out of ash juniper bark, and they've evolved over the thousands of years this relationship with the tree.
Herein lies the struggle. Some consider native Texas junipers a weed when they invade pastures and outcompete grasses and wildflowers. And like the warbler, people need places to live as well.
A lot of the forest areas that used to house golden-cheeked warblers are now housing human beings. So much of the reason for the species being listed as endangered has been because of changes we've made to the landscape.
Gotta find a good rock.
To get an idea on population numbers.
And this mist net's 6 meters long.
The duo teams up to catch some.
It's almost invisible. We've actually caught people who aren't paying close attention and walking close to the net. We try to find habitat where we have a narrow opening in which we can have the birds come down to a low perch. And it's where they're gonna wanna cross back and forth.
He's moving around a lot.
We're gonna entice him down with the song.
He's trying very hard to figure out where this rival is. Ah, close. He sounds agitated now. Got him. It's always important to see which side he came in on. Well, you managed to get your head twisted in there pretty good, didn't you, buddy? All right. Let's put the bands on. His right leg now has an orange band over a silver band.
One of the things that banding helps us with is longevity studies.
So it's mauve over dark green, orange over silver.
And what we're finding is some of the older growth habitat, closed canopy habitat, seems to be some of the favorite habitat for these guys.
You're a feisty little critter. It's really good to see them snap because that means that he's very alert, he's still in good shape, and then just let him fly off. Whoosh.
They've noticed the thicker and more remote the cedar forest, the better the chance of survival for the nestlings.
Because there's higher densities of predators at the urban edge, that's much more dangerous environment for the endangered golden-cheeked warbler. In the past, we've had a researcher who has been able to put cameras on nests and was actually taken film, and she was able to catch certain predators at the nest.
One of the warbler's predators is the Texas rat snake.
You know, we watch these nests from the beginning. We, you know, see them go through the egg-laying process, the nestling process, and many times just before they fledge, we'll lose them. It's a tough thing to watch because, you know, we've gotten to know these birds over a long period of time.
Many nestlings do survive. Jim is back to see if that female he spotted earlier has produced any chicks.
We're gonna be checking on this golden cheek nest. It's been about 7 days since we've been here. So we're gonna check to make sure that the nest is still active.
The female's coming in, and she's got a caterpillar. Caterpillars are wonderful protein sources this time of year.
This mom's been busy with three new chicks that are 7 days old.
The male's coming in now. He's been banded. He was banded 2 years ago.
The future of the golden-cheeked warbler is dependent on prime nesting habitat. Preservation of these hill country cedar forests is the key before these warblers disappear altogether.
One of the great things about the Balcones Canyonlands Preserve is it's now coming back that we have trees here that are over 100 years old. We're setting the stage here for the return of those old growth forests.
Golden-cheeked warbler is continuing to face pressures from urban growth, from changes that we are doing to its habitat and to the planet. We hope with the establishment of the Balcones Canyonlands Preserve, putting this land in some protection, that we can help them to survive into the future.